Good evening guys, welcome to Daily Current Affairs series. Today we will discuss about 20th April current affairs. Myself Sunny Sandeep, welcome to my channel Gear Up for Group 1 exam. Let us discuss the current affairs. The first one, e-commerce firms cannot supply non-essential goods, says government. We know that there are different types of platforms are there regarding e-commerce. They are, first one, Amazon, Flipkart, Myntra and Snapdeal. These are the e-commerce platforms. Why government came up with this norm in this pandemic situation? Usually e-commerce platforms will deliver different types of goods, in that mobiles, clothing, different fashion products, groceries, everything at the door they will deliver. But in this pandemic situation, they have to deliver only essential goods. What are the essential goods? Masks and hand sanitizers came under Essentials Commodity Act, that is 1955. Up to June 30, central government given masks and hand sanitizers and essential commodity acts. What this act tells about? There are different types of essential commodities are under this one, like oil seeds, food products. Now recently masks and hand sanitizers comes under ECA. Why government came up with decision? Because there is a blockage of essential items. If suppose no supply or no delivery of these masks and hand sanitizers, people will suffer. For that, government came up with e-commerce platforms has to deliver essential goods only, and don't supply or don't deliver non-essential goods not required in this pandemic situations. This can prohibits hoarding and black marketing of essential commodities. These rules are comes under Disaster Management Act, that is 2005. Next one, editorial explanation. In this editorial explanation, I have taken economy lockdown. In this pandemic situation, our corona situation, we are facing economy is under threat. No works are going on. How economy will boost? If there is a work or anything, then economy will accelerate. Otherwise it is in a dead stage or in a stable state. For that, we have to make availability of policy support. We have to do after this COVID situation, if we are fighting more, we are fighting against COVID-19. This situation won't be until at some time it will reduce or we will win against this COVID situations. After that, we have to ready with some policy supports. Then only we can boost our economy situation. Otherwise, it will go to depression state also. We have to face different types of inflations. Inflation is more. For that, there is an international body is there, that is IMF, that is International Monetary Fund. It will predict economy situation throughout the world. It will give some predictions or it will give some projections regarding previous years and forecasting to future year. Now IMF has to junk all its previous projections for economic output in 2020. Why? Because in 2020 pandemic corona came. For that, IMF has to junk all its projections. But it is telling global growth would be low, about 0.1 points lower. This may fade in the second half of the 2020, that is after June it may fade. For that, we have to ready with our legs to run our economy boostage. This is the economy lockdown in our editorial explanation. Next one, Goa is the first to turn virus free. Goa on Sunday became the first zero COVID-19 state. In Goa, 7 positive cases are recorded at. On Sunday, all 7 cases with no fatalities or no deaths, all 7 cases are recovered and and came with a negative state. From April 3rd, no positive cases are recorded. Dr. Savant said special thanks to who worked in frontline workers like police, doctors and municipality workers. The chief minister said government offices would resume 100% work from Monday. There are seafarers are facing so many problems who stuck in different countries. They are unable to come back to our country. For that, when central government came up with some clear policy, then only we can arrange our seafarers to come back or to state or country. In that meeting also, seafarers issue also addressed. Next one, Islamophobia is rising in India, said by OIC. What is OIC? That is a Organization of Islamic Cooperation. When it is founded in 1969, consisting of 57 member states. The name itself, Organization of Islamic Cooperation. There are different Muslim countries are there, like UAE, Pakistan, Afghanistan. There are different countries are there. But at now, no attendance of India in the OIC. But greatly, last year, Sushma Swaraj, first Indian leader since 1969 to attend Islamic Nations, that is invited by UAE government. Almost 50 years, after 50 years, Sushma Swaraj is the only leader attended that Islamic Nations meeting. Why OIC came up with this statement? Why OIC is asking to protect rights of Muslims? There are two situations happened. For that two situations said by US Commission on International Religious Freedom, USCIRF. What are the two situations? The first one, India, Pakistan and Cambodia for fail to protect vulnerable religious communities and increase stigmatization. That is the first situation. And second situation, patient segregation. What is patient segregation? In India, according reports of USIRF, there is a separate isolation for Muslims and there is a separate isolation for Hindus. That is a patient segregation who are affected with COVID-19. If you are dealing with like that, Islamophobia will increase in India. That's why OIC urging Indian government to protect the rights of Muslims. OIC is a very important concept for UPPSC and APPSC. Please read it once again. Next one, PM calls for unity in COVID-19. There are statements given by Modi, COVID-19 does not see race, religion, color, caste, creed, language or border before striking. Our response and conduct therefore should be attached primacy to unity and brotherhood. Countering to or after OIC urging that to protect the Muslim rights, our Modi ji, Prime Minister, said these words, COVID-19 does not see race, religion, color, caste, creed, language or border before striking. We have to unity. India is famous for unity in diversity. There is a different types of people in India, like Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Jains, Buddhists and Christians also. That is unity in diversity. But what is said by our Modi ji is that in this situation, the need of our is to think business and lifestyle models that are easily adaptable. In this pandemic situation, COVID-19 is giving opportunity to think in better way. Youthful nation known for its innovative zeal can take the lead in providing new work culture. We have so much youth population. With that youth population, you have to come up with innovative ideas. We have to give some support to our nation. Then only we can fight against this COVID-19 situation. It is the technology that diminishes bureaucratic hierarchies, eliminated middlemen and accelerated welfare measures. In this statement, he given his government is focusing on technology like Jandan Yojana accounts, direct benefit transfers, that is DBT, and Aadhaar linkage. Like simple word is there, JAM, that is Jandan, Aadhaar and mobile linkage. This Modi government is came up with technology innovations. We have to unity to fight in this COVID-19 situations. Be ready for that. Lastly, I promise to make a different types of national parks in every state. Now we will discuss what are the national parks in Madhya Pradesh. The first one, Satpura National Park, Bandhavgarh National Park, Kanha National Park, Pench National Park, Madhav National Park, Panna National Park, Sanjay Dubri National Park, Fazil National Park, One Vihar National Park. These are the important national parks in Madhya Pradesh. Please read it once again, then only you will remember these national parks. From national parks, we are getting at least one bit. Please concentrate on that. Thank you very much. Please subscribe to my channel, Gear Up for Group 1 Exam. This is Sunny Sandeep signing off. Take care. Bye-bye.